Can we make a computer sing and emulate a vocalist or even a full choir? I've been testing some up-and-coming AI technology that promises to do exactly that, and I wanted to share a little preview with you in today's video. Now, if you've been in this field a while, you know that there are earlier generation attempts to do this. There are numerous choir sample libraries out there. And in fact, I've done videos on many of these on my channel. I'll leave links below. Up until the past couple years, we really only had one way of accomplishing this task, and that was by using sampled voices or sampled choirs. And largely, that was done by sampling individual notes or syllables by singers or choirs and then putting them into a sampler. So for example, you have the singer recording ah, and then you map that to the keyboard so that the performer can play an ah when you hit that key. This is fine as far as it goes, but you can probably see the inherent limitation in this approach. First of all, you're limited to whatever the sample manufacturer recorded, which often means the stock vowels, oohs, ohs, ahs, and so on. And then some manufacturers went beyond that and started recording syllables. But the problem with that is real language involves so many more syllables than can ever be recorded and put into a sampler. There are almost unlimited combinations of the possible vowels, consonants, and inflections that are in use in real language and real singing. There are a few manufacturers who tried to develop a word builder kind of software where you can type in phrases and then it would select from the pre-recorded syllables the best matches to try and cobble together some kind of performance. But the end result, in my experience, was not really close to realistic. Now, you might be aware, in the past couple of years, there's been an explosion of AI vocal technologies that take a completely different approach to this problem. I've covered a couple of these in previous videos. Again, I'll leave the links below. But today, I'd like to look at a brand new one that I think is extremely promising. It's called Cantai, and it's billed as AI-powered vocal synthesis for opera and choral music. You can check out a free trial yourself on the Cantai.app website, but in the next couple of minutes, I'm going to run it through a quick demo and see what I can make it do. I do want to stress that Cantai is very much a preview technology at this stage. I'm using the online renderer in the website, whereas the developer's goal over the next few months is to actually build it into a plugin similar to Note Performer and have it integrate directly into notation programs like Dorico, Sibelius, MuseScore, and more. So there are likely to be significant improvements to this technology coming soon. But for today, I just wanted to capture a snapshot of where it is right now so that you can check it out and use it or support it as you see fit. And by the way, this video is not sponsored in any way. I'm a paying customer of this service, and I'm looking forward to using it specifically for choral demos and things like that. So without any further ado, let's dive into Cantai and see what I can make it do. So let's start today's adventure in Dorico, where I have input the first four measures of the Hallelujah Chorus in its normal traditional SATB configuration. Now, I mentioned a minute ago, this is a preview technology here, so there are a couple of workarounds I'm going to employ to make this work the way it should. I learned the hard way that for some reason in the translation process, the tenor treble clef, which is normally notated an octave above where it actually sounds, did not get translated properly. So because of that, to get this ready for Cantai, I'm literally going to transpose this an octave down so that it's notated as sounding. And now it's ready to export. So I'm going to go to Dorico's file menu and go to export. In my case, I'm going to choose Music XML. I'll leave the options just like this, uncompressed XML, and I don't need each layout as a separate file. I just need that master full choir layout. Once I've got that Music XML file exported from Dorico, I need to employ one more workaround. That's because the current version of Cantai can't import Music XML directly, but I'm told it will be able to do so very soon. So I'm going to use this free online service called Utaformatics 3, and I'm simply going to import my Music XML file into the engine. Once I do that, this website is going to ask me what kind of file do I want to export this as, and the answer is MIDI. I can leave all of these configuration settings at their default, and then I'll just click export to get a MIDI file. And if you're wondering why I didn't just export a MIDI file directly from Dorico, it's because the current version of Dorico does not export lyrics inside MIDI files, which is another update that I'm told is coming pretty soon. So hang tight, I bet in the weeks and months to come, this is gonna get a lot simpler. I also wanna note at the time I'm making this video, if you're working in MuseScore, MuseScore does export MIDI files with lyrics embedded, so you don't need this intermediate step. Okay, so in any case, now that I have my MIDI file that has the lyrics embedded, I'm ready to load it into Cantai. And this is what the beta version of the web interface looks like. I'll just drag my MIDI file into that area, and Cantai will begin processing it. Once it's analyzed the structure of the MIDI file, it's ready to assign voices to each stave. As I click on the top stave, the soprano, I could assign it to Lucia. In this example, I'm actually going to assign it to choral female. The same for the alto part. And for tracks 3 and 4, I'll assign them to choral male. Now, because I've chosen choral voices here, I can actually tell it how big I want the section to be. Right now, the slider goes from 2 to 3. In the future, it's going to go much higher than that. And then I can select the hall size and the reverb amount. Let's go ahead and start rendering this thing. And Kantai took about 30 or 40 seconds to render that 4-measure phrase. And you can see that I've got waveforms for each of the 4 parts, which I can play individually or download. And down here is the full mix of all 4 voices together. So I think it's only appropriate. Let's go ahead and listen to that.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Now that is a pretty interesting rendering. By no means is it perfect, but if you really analyze it, you can tell it's got a lot of potential. There were a couple of pronunciation glitches, which I know the Kantai team is working on daily. They've literally said that pronunciation glitches are the easiest things to fix, and they are stomping those bugs out as soon as they can. But really, if I needed to get it better right now, I could go back to my Dorico file and I could experiment with different syllables. Of course, the word hallelujah is an oddly spelled word in English with the J-A-H. I'm not sure exactly what caused Kantai to pronounce it the way it did, but I feel pretty confident I could figure out how to work around that if I needed to. As far as the timbre of the voices, you know, I would say it's pretty good. The fidelity wasn't as high as I would wish it was. There were aspects of it that definitely felt like they were machine generated. But then again, I just really want to stress this is very much an emerging technology in its very first iteration here. And I can extrapolate what this thing is going to be capable of in 6 or 12 or 18 months from now. While I'm here, I feel like I do want to just have a little bit of fun with this, so I'm just going to download that full mix of all the singers singing together. And let me switch over into my DAW digital performer, where I imported an orchestra-only recording of the Hallelujah Chorus. And now I'm going to import my Kantai-generated vocals, and I'll see if I can make them into something. This might take me a moment to spot these new vocals into the correct place, but let's see if I'm even in the neighborhood of something that could work. That's not bad, and I even got the tempo in the neighborhood of right, which is a complete guess because this is a live performance not recorded to a click. And I think the last ingredient on this might be I put a little bit of reverb on that choir. Certainly not 100% worth, but let's try maybe 30% reverb in a large hall. Well, anyway, that is a quick no-frills demonstration of what Kantai is able to do. As I've mentioned throughout this video, this is extremely, extremely early technology, but it's one that I'm really excited to see where it can go. There's a lot being done in the AI vocal space right now, with apps that can transform voices, generate voices, all kinds of things. To my knowledge, this is the only one that's able to do it from a choral perspective. So what's next for Kantai? As I've been testing and working with it, I've learned a lot about what the future plans are for this app. Ultimately, the goal is for it to be as seamless for vocals as Note Performer is for orchestral instruments. And if you're not familiar with Note Performer, you really need to be. Check out my video on that. I'll link to it below. The main major development steps that will come next for Kantai is the development of its plugin format, which ultimately means it'll be able to interface directly with notation programs and read choral scores as they're being written, without the need to export via MIDI or Music XML, then import into the web interface, and so on. Also, I know they're doing daily fixes on pronunciation glitches, so the stuff that you heard in my demo is likely to be fixed quickly. As far as purchasing and trying Kantai, there's a free trial on their website. You can try it for yourself if you want. You can also pay and sign up for a lifetime plan access to Kantai, which is what I did personally, as a way to support its future development. There is also a Kickstarter if you prefer to support the program that way. And there's an active Discord server where you can chat with other users and even beta test the program and help make it better. Links to both are down below.
I definitely think this is a vital technology worth keeping your ears on if you do any kind of composing or arranging in vocal or choral music, because ultimately this technology has broad implications for composers who need quick, machine-generated demos of their work. I'll be very excited to see what comes next for Cantai. I hope I've piqued your interest with this thing. Do give it a try on their website and support it if you're inclined to do so, and post some examples of things that you've made it do. As always, I really appreciate your support on this channel. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next one.